Hello guys, today we are going to create a simple panda using ZBrush and by using some very basic tools. But you can use all those tools for your high detail sculpts too. So let's get started. When you first open up the ZBrush, you will get the ZBrush homepage. We don't need that. Then Lightbox will open up. Close the Lightbox by pressing comma key on your keyboard or just simply hide it by pressing hide option. After that, click on the simple brush icon and from 3D meshes, choose Sphere 3D. Drag on your canvas with your stylus to create the sphere. After that, you can change the material by going on basic material icon and choose matte cap gray, the most famous material in ZBrush. Then go to transform menu and press activate symmetry. The shortcut is X key on your keyboard. I'm using PureRef for my reference placement. The downloading link is in the description. Now for sculpting, you need brushes. Press D on your keyboard to get all the brushes. Then choose Move Brush. Press S on your keyboard for increasing or decreasing the size of your brush. Before editing the Sphere 3D, you have to make it a Polymesh 3D by clicking Make Polymesh 3D. And for going into Edit Mode, press T on your keyboard. Then just start editing the shape. For adding new geometry as a subtool, go to the tool menu which is already available on the right side, then go to the subtool menu and press append, choose Sphere 3D from quick picks. Then select the geometry from subtool menu and press W on your keyboard to get gizmo, which will help you to move your geometry. You can move, scale and rotate using gizmo. Then with the symmetry activated, adjust the shape. Press B for brushes and select clay builder brush with which you can edit the shape. By pressing Alt, you can sculpt inward on the surface and without Alt, you can sculpt outward on the surface. By pressing Shift on your keyboard, the smooth brush will get activated by which you can smooth the surface. I am appending a new sphere for the ears and placing it using the gizmo and then shaping it using Move Brush. As for brush size, after that, for getting a symmetrical copy of your ear on the other side, go to Z plugin. With the ear geometry selected, then go to Subtool Master, then press Mirror. With the default setting, press OK. You can also adjust the mirror axis from this menu. You can directly select the different subtool using Alt button on your keyboard and pressing onto the geometry which you want to select. By using Clay Builder and Move Brush, I am creating an eye socket. Then for eyeballs, I appended a sphere, placed it with the help of Gizmo, then shaped it with Clay Builder brush. Then by going to Z plugin, then Subtool Master, then Mirror, I got the other eye. For merging two different subtool, you can go to the Merge option. I am placing it according to my needs. Another useful feature in ZBrush is Dynamesh. For Dynamesh, go to Tool menu and scroll for the Dynamesh option. Then press Dynamesh. By activating Dynamesh, every time you press Ctrl and drag on the canvas, you will get nice even quad topology. Now for creating eyebrows, I am going to use masking feature. You can press Ctrl on your keyboard and start creating mask on the geometry. For erasing the mask, press Ctrl plus Alt on your keyboard and rub over the masked area. For sharpening the mask, go to the masking menu. Press Sharpen Mask. You can make adjustment to your mask from that menu. Then for extracting the geometry from the masked area, go to the tool menu
Extract option and adjust the smooth and thick using sliders. When I got what I needed, I pressed accept button. Then I smoothed the geometry and created a mirror for the other eyebrow. Adjusting the eyebrow according to the reference. I'm adjusting the ears and eye socket area, then nose area. For creating a sharp edge near eye socket, I use damp sanded brush by pressing B key on the keyboard. I created an edge by damp sanded brush. Then for proper shape, I used a feature called clay polish. Then going to the clay polish feature and with the default setting, I pressed clay polish. And after that, I smooth out the other areas. For creating the sharp edges, you can adjust the other options which are given with the clay polish feature. Edge slider is one of them. Again, I created the nose using the same masking trick which I used for the eyebrows. For removing the mask, you can control click and drag on the canvas once. By using damp sanded, I created the mouth area. Then for making hands, I appended a cylinder and used gizmo for proper placement. Then with dynamesh feature turned on, I started sculpting the hands. You have to rotate the canvas a lot to get proper shape. Look from every angle. Then for legs, I first selected the body mesh, then turned on the dynamesh feature and masked the area from where I want the legs to come out. After creating mask, with control pressed on the keyboard, click once on the canvas. By clicking, the mask will get reversed. Then by using gizmo, I extruded the legs. Then after that, I press control on the keyboard, drag once on the canvas to remove the mask and dragged again to get dynamesh to function on this mesh, which will turn this mesh into equal quads. Then I smooth out the legs and adjusted it using move and clay builder brush. For creating the stomach fold around legs, I used masking trick. I masked the legs and moved the stomach down. Then I shaped the stomach and backside too, by looking through different angles. Then I mirrored the other hand and shaped it. Then I took a duplicate of the nose and used the geometry for the hairs. Now the poly painting part. I applied a toy plastic material on the eyeballs by going to the material icon and choosing the toy plastic. Keep in mind, before applying the material, you have to click on the mRGB from above and choose the desired color and desired material. Then go to the color menu and click fill object. And for painting according to your needs, go to brushes and choose paint brush. And with the color selected, you can paint directly onto the mesh. For sharp brush, decrease the focal shift of the brush. And the more division you have on your model, the more detail your polypaint will look. For other black parts of the body, I use the basic material too, with black color, and fill that on ears, hairs, and eyebrows. Then with paintbrush, I painted the black spot near the eye area, lip area, chest area, and the legs area. Then by adjusting the render setting, you can render the model by going to the render menu. So finally our cute panda model is ready. For more such videos, don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates. And for any suggestions or your questions, write it in the comment box. Thank you so much for watching.